Welcome to the fifth example of describing and graphing trig transformations. This one deals with the cosecant function. We have y equals 2 cosecant of the quantity 2 pi x plus pi plus 3. Again, the first thing we should recognize is we do have to factor this quantity here in order to fit the form to identify a, b, c, and d. Let's start by doing that. We'll have y equals 2 cosecant. Now here we're going to factor out 2 pi. We're left with x plus, if we factor out 2 pi from pi, we're going to be left with 1 half plus 3. Let's check this. 2 pi x and 2 pi times 1 half does equal pi. So now it's in the form that we need to recognize the values of a, b, c, and d. And even though we're referencing the sine function here, we should recognize that a is equal to 2, b is equal to 2 pi, d is equal to negative 1 half, if it has to be x minus d, and c would be equal to positive 3. Now let's go ahead and list the amplitude, period, phase shift, and vertical shift for the cosecant function. Careful, because cosecant does not have an amplitude, so there is no amplitude. Remember, cosecant extends upward and downward forever. The period will be 2 pi divided by b. Well, 2 pi divided by b, which is also 2 pi, is equal to 1. So the period is equal to 1 unit. The phase shift is determined by d. And to fit this form, we would have x minus negative 1 half. So it's going to be 1 half unit to the left. Remember, if it's x plus 1 half, it's going to be to the left. If it was x minus 1 half, it'd be to the right. And then c determines the vertical shift, so this graph is shifted up 3 units. Now this is a pretty involved graph, so what we're going to do is actually graph y equals 2 sine 2 pi times the quantity x plus 1 half plus 3. We can use the graph of the sine function to help us graph the cosecant function. So let's see if we can set this up using the same information we have to the right here, except now we will graph the sine function with an amplitude of 2. But either way, this is a pretty involved graph. Notice the midline is going to be at y equals 3 because we have a vertical shift up 3 units. So let's go ahead and mark that off. 1, 2, 3. Here's the new midline for our sine function. The amplitude would be positive 2, which means we'll go up 2 to 5 for our maximums, and down 2 to 1 for the minimum values. And then the period would be 1 unit, so we normally would graph this from 0 to 1. But since we have a phase shift of 1 half unit to the left, we'll actually start this graph at negative 1 half and end it at positive 1 half because of our phase shift. So let's go ahead and clear this off to avoid any confusion. And then from here, we'll go ahead and graph our sine function with all these transformations, and that's going to help us graph the given cosecant function. But before we graph this sine function on this interval that will be one complete period, let's go and divide it into fourths. So this would be negative 1/4, and this would be positive 1/4. So the sine function starts at the midline. The next fourth, it's up at a maximum. The next fourth, it's at the midline. The next fourth is at a minimum. And the next fourth is back at the midline. Now again, this is the sine function, and I'm going to make it dashed, because it's not really the graph we want, but we're going to use it to determine the graph of our cosecant function. Okay, now we're ready to graph the given function, the cosecant function. Remember, the sine function and the cosecant function are reciprocals of one another. So where this sine function would be equal to 0, the corresponding cosecant function would have a vertical asymptote. So we'll have vertical asymptotes here, here, and here. And then from here, remember that corresponding cosecant and sine functions share this maximum value for sine here, And then the cosecant function would approach the asymptotes from here and here. And they also would share this point here where we have a minimum value on the sine function. And from here, it would approach the vertical asymptotes here and here. Another way to remember this as well is that where the sine function is concave down, the cosecant function will be concave up. And where the sine function is concave up, the cosecant function will be concave down. So there is a lot going on here, and that reciprocal value of sine and cosecant is a little bit awkward here because of the +3 that's not involved with the actual sine and cosecant function, as well as the extra factor of 2 in the front.